Okay, we start now with the third part of my presentation, the more pleasant part of Buxus. A lot of people say, okay, there are problems with Buxus, and say, we don't work anymore with Buxus because the problems are too big. But also with other plans, there are some problems. And we want to have another solution, say, okay, we're going to create better Buxus. And how we want to do that? With a breeding program. And when we started in 2007, we start collecting a lot of data, because a lot of things we didn't know about the different species in the world. We start with our DNA investigation, but it's not only the resistance against diseases what's important, also how the plant grows, how the leaves are, how the frost resistance, leaf shapes, winter color. There are a lot of other things when you start a breeding program. Genome size, also very important, ploidy levels. And then the genetic relationship with that we proved with our DNA investigation together with Katrijn van Laren from the ILVO. We published this in 2011. All this data is important to start up a good breeding program, is our base. First things we did were making crossbreedings, and one of the problems there is, yeah, you need flowers at the same time. And when you know that, for instance, Buxus microphylla vercoriana flowers in February with very nice smelling flowers, and Buxus balearica, for instance, flowers in May, you have a problem because you need flowers at the same time. We all studied these flowering times, the different species. Then we made some crossings. At this moment we have made more than 150 crossing combinations. When you have made these crosses, you're gonna get seeds, but it takes quite a long time to germinate for these seeds, and we have to study also how we can break this seed dormancy and let them germinate faster. A lot of research. Then after, when we have young plants, young seedlings, we have a controlled inoculation at the ILVO Institute with Calonectra, with the spores, to see how resistant they are. I will tell you more about it in a minute. Then after, when you have good seedlings, good resistant ones, you have to do further selection. Grow shape, leaf color, winter hardiness, all these things also very important. Not only the disease resistant. And then you have start propagation and commercial production. There's a lot of work. Here you can see some pictures of the flowers. First picture, you see the pistil in the middle with anthers around. Then you see the fruits in the picture in the middle, the seeds, black seeds, and there are six seeds in one fruit. And when you, mostly in July when they ripen, when there's a very warm day, it's like popcorn, and they pop from maybe 3 meters away. It's very special. You see some pictures at the ILVO Institute and at a nursery. We inoculate the plants with spore, the same concentration, so we can see how good they are against the box blight. Later on, we test them in our greenhouses further. Here is a schedule how we started in 2007 with the research. With the DNA research also. And now we made the first crossings 2009, 2010. Every year we make about 5,000, we have 5,000 seedlings. Just 2 years, 10,000 seedlings. And then we inoculate these plants with the same spore concentration. And we kept 3,000 plants after this first inoculation. But now, this test was not strong enough for me. As I said, we have to find another solution to get a stronger test. And one of these things was to create a test field where we can have outside conditions, like in our nurseries, like in our garden, but it's with a very higher disease pressure. We start with that in 2013, and from the 3,000 seedlings that were not in that were not sick after inoculation, we kept only 150 after the field test. It's a very strong test. And at the end of 2015, we chose four different hybrids in final selection, and then we start with propagation and growing young plants. And these four hybrids you can see here, this is the end of 2015 we chose them. The first one is a fast growing Skylight, very nice plant, grows very fast. The second one is Heritage. It's like Sempervirens, a little bit more compact, but grows quite well. Then we have a slow-growing Renaissance, good for low hedges. And another one is the Babylon Beauty. It's more lower hedges and ground covering. All these four hybrids are from a different genetic combination, and that's also important on long term. You see some better pictures, older pictures. Renaissance, perfect for low hedges. Very nice leaves, dark green leaves. Then we have the Babylon Beauty. It's a little bit more yellow, light green leaves, ideal for ground covering. You can see it on the picture. It grows very, very wide. A very nice plant also. And they have a little twist in the leaves. It's very special. Then we have the Heritage. It's more the look-alike like the Sempervirens. It can have a little bit more winter color. You have to give good fertilizer. And then the fourth one is the Skylight. It's the fast growing and it grows very fast. How we want to because a lot of people don't work with Buxus anymore because they have problems. We don't work with Buxus anymore. We want to work with ambassadors. And the best ambassador, I think, are the historical gardeners. They are used to work with Buxus for hundreds of years. And they have enough knowledge to grow them well. And that are first line of ambassadors. And in Europe, we work with three of these ambassadors. In France, we have Château de Villandry, a well-known garden at the Château near the Loire. The first that Buxus plants are planted there in October 2019, and we have had, I think, a few weeks ago, the third time we sent plants there to this garden. Very nice garden. The second garden is Palais het Loo in the Netherlands. We planted the King's Garden in April 2020. They grow very well. You can find at the website description how they grow. And the third historical gardens in Germany is the Hennhauser Garten. Also planted the first plants in April 2020. That's our first line of ambassadors. The second line of ambassadors will be, now I think, the more exclusive gardens, good garden architect, people that have enough knowledge to talk their customers about Buxus and how to take care of Buxus. We want to introduce the better Buxus hybrids under a brand. It's called Better Buxus. And those four varieties are protected with the European Plant Variety Right. And we introduce them also in America. In America it will be a plant patent. And the production is there started up now for America and Canada also. Yeah. They will be exclusive on the market, not on the free market. Because it's important that we work with people that have enough knowledge and can tell to the customers how to take care of business. That's not only about the disease, and also giving water when it's dry, giving fertilizer when it's needed, is take care of the plants properly. The first 5 years we only will do the propagation and production. Later on we will work with a small group of breeders in Europe. We work now for every European country. We work with distributors, and you can find on the website betterbookses.com where we are. But it's important that we work with people that can give good advice. That's important. I want to thank my daughter Elin to help me with the PowerPoint. It was a lot of work, but I hope I give you, some answers. If there are any questions, please ask them. I think you can send it to the website of the EBTS UK. You can even see that. Thank you for your attention, and best greetings from Belgium, and stay healthy.